Hello, fire accidents can happen at home, at road and in industries. We have seen some of the fire accidents. To prevent fire, we must know what are all the components must be present. For a fire to start, three components must be present. Those are oxygen, fuel and temperature. This can be denoted by a triangle called fire triangle. This has oxygen as base, fuel and temperature as other two sides. Prevention or suppression of fire is possible by reducing temperature of burning material. By cutting short the supply of oxygen to the surface of burning material, and by removing fuel from burning area. Fires are classified into different classes based on their fire sources, and it requires specific extinguishing agent to put out the fire. Now let us see what are they. Fires that occur from ordinary combustibles like wood, paper and cloth are grouped under class A, which is denoted by a green triangle. Fires in flammable liquids like oils, solvents and petroleum products are grouped under class B, and this is denoted by a red square. Fires that occur from electrical sources are grouped under class C, is denoted by blue circle. A fire can start anywhere at any time due to unsafe use of electrical equipments, open flames, welding processes, and bad housekeeping. Fire prevention can be achieved by maintaining cleanliness, orderliness in plant areas. Fire control can be done by portable fire extinguishers and mobile appliances. Regular maintenance and inspection of machinery, plant and equipment will improve cleanliness. Keeping storage area obstacle free and storing chemicals and other materials properly in its place will improve orderliness. Keeping all the necessary firefighting equipment within easy reach will help to fight fire in initial stages itself. Portable type fire extinguishers are more effective in extinguishing fire in early stages. Soda acid type extinguisher is suitable for class A fire. This has handle, plunger and nozzle. Acid fuel is kept in a cage just below the plunger, and sodium bicarbonate solution is kept in the cylinder. When the plunger is struck, acid and sodium bicarbonate mixes and the carbon dioxide generated forces the solution out of the extinguisher. Okay, now we shall see the demonstration. Strike the plunger against hot surface. Direct the jet emerging from the nozzle on the base of fire. Foam type extinguisher is suitable for class B fire. This has handle, plunger and nozzle. The inner compartment contains solution of aluminium sulfate and the outer compartment holds a solution of sodium bicarbonate and foam stabilizer. To operate the extinguisher, pull the plunger, turn the extinguisher, direct the jet to the fire. Dry chemical powder type is suitable for class B and class C fires. This has safety clip, knob, rubber hose, nozzle and squeezing lever. The chemical powder is kept in the main shell and carbon dioxide gas is held under high pressure in a sealed cartridge. When operated, carbon dioxide gas escapes from the broken cartridge to main shell and pushes out the powder in the form of fog. To operate, keep it in upright position, remove the safety clip, strike the knob, direct the rubber hose to the seat of fire, squeeze the nozzle lever. Carbon dioxide type extinguisher is mainly suitable for class C fires. This is locking pin, handle, flow control valve and discharge horn. Carbon dioxide is retained in the cylinder as liquid under pressure. Discharge tube is situated in the center of the cylinder. To operate, remove the locking pin, unscrew the flow control valve, direct the discharge horn straight to the fire. So far in this program, we have seen the components of fire, classification of fire sources and different types of fire extinguishers to control fire. Thank you. Human life is precious. The control of fire play a vital role in saving life from fire accidents, and this must be done with suitable methods.